boy. Today we're gonna make us some roast beef sandwiches or roast beef po' boys. Down in New Orleans they call this New Orleans roast beef with debris. That means that you cook the roast long enough to where it falls apart by looking at it. So you got debris and pieces of meat in the gravy. Somebody wrote in wanting to know how to make an Italian beef. It's going to be the same thing as this, except you add bell peppers to it and more garlic than what I'm going to use for this. So I got a USDA Choice shoulder roast, and I got some Riesling's po' boy bread by the G.H. Lean. Let me make sure I got that right. Yeah, baked by G.H. Liedenheimer Baking Company out of New Orleans. It's a real good po' boy bread. And G.H. Liedenheimer has been in business since, I think, the 1800s. It's a pretty old company. Anyway, so what we're going to do is open this roasted beast and put a little slappy mama on it. And we're going to saute it or brown it down in a skillet with some Earl on it. What kind of Earl? Whatever kind I got. Alright. Into the pot. See, I didn't clean the stove because I knew this was going to be splattering all over the place. Alright, I just throw some onions in there. They just rough chopped. See, just rough. Who cares? They're going to cook the pieces. Trust me, boy. Come on, butts up. Now, we got to get a little wine in here. Not a little, a good bit. Makes a rich, rich gravy, boy. And you see the color on that roast. That ain't burned no, boy. That's what's going to make the gravy brown, brown, brown. See, them onions are breaking up that flan in the bottom of that pan. See that flan down there? Them onions is breaking all that up. And this wine here going to help break that up some more. Pick it all up. You heard Ms. JB? It smells good. Damn right it does. Now if you can see, I got that roast standing up on its edge to brown that side too. I had this side against the side of the pot, and that's why this browned up, and that's some fat right there, and that's gonna melt down in that gravy and be damn fine. All right, now all them onions done released their sugar. See there? Yep, whir the hell out of this thing, man. Make you a spin arounder deal. And that's dragging the side of the pot, you see. Now, get him up to heat good. Because the wine is cold. It's Cabernet Sauvignon. Or Cabaret Sauvignon. Good bit. See, that stops the cooking. We gotta add some water. Oh, what the hell, JB? Pour it all in there. That's probably a good half a pit. Because this is two or three light. It's one of them big ass bottles. I don't know how big it is. It says it's big. You see, it's big. It ain't a regular fit size. Now that we got liquid in there, we can put these garlics up in there. And they gonna cook the pieces also. What goes real, real good in this, some thyme. Some oregano. Oh, too much, JB. Maybe a good tablespoon of oregano. And we gotta add some more cooking liquid to this, which is gonna be water
and beef bouillon cubes.
Like I said, you want to make an Italian beef, double that garlic, put some bell peppers in there to saute when you put your onions in, and that's going to make your Italian beef. Now if you want to slice it, that's a different story. It's on you. But if you cook this down long enough, it's going to be in pieces. And you can just bust little pieces off of what's left and make the sandwich. It don't have to be sliced. It's the way Cajuns do things. I ain't in Chicago. I ain't never lived in Chicago. Been there once, but I ain't going back. I'm going to stay down here. Now, just before your wine comes up to a boil, add you some water to this. You don't want boil straight wine. It's going to make it bitter. Now that it's got water in it, it's a different animal. Why you think that is? Google it. I'm going to put a couple of these little square looking cow cubes in there, simply for the salt. It's the only reason. Because we already made a beef stock. That's what you see right there. Now this here is a mild grenade sauce. I don't know. This is what would be served on a Chicago Italian style po' boy. And this one's in vegetable oil. Now here's a Riesling po' boy bread. Got some blue plate mayonnaise. And we're going to go ahead and take some of the blue plate mayonnaise and brush it all over there. We're going to want to put some tomatoes on here. We want to put some lettuce on here. It's some New Orleans style, Cajun style. It's not Chicago style. This is more healthy for you. Now here this meat is just falling apart. See that? See that how it's falling apart? And we're going to put it on this po' boy. So let me go ahead and load this up with some meat. Now let's go ahead and put some of this roast beast gravy. See that? On there. And that's fortified with the wine. Now, New Orleans roast beef po' boy with the breeze. How about that? Now let's go ahead and put some of this roast beef gravy. See that? On there. And that's fortified with the wine. Now, New Orleans roast beef po' boy with the breeze. How about that? And now for the doggie's meal, we have chicken marsala with Italian vegetables, mushrooms, and steak tips with a mustard mayonnaise honey potato salad, steamed veggies, steamed carrots. Are you getting hungry, dogs? My dogs eat better than most of you people.
Yeah, dogs.